All GS4 drives come with two digital outputs and two relay outputs standard. And you can add more discrete outputs or relay outputs with the optional I/O cards for a total of 8 possible outputs. The drive can use the outputs to indicate all the items in this list, including if the drive is running, if it's at frequency, what the torque status is, if dynamic braking is active, forward, reverse, etc. And to use it, you just put the number of the function you want in the drive's output terminal's parameter. For example, let's put the at frequency set point, which is a 2, and output 1, which is parameter 319. Now when the drive reaches speed, this LED I connected to output 1 lights up. Perfect. Well, that's all there is to it. But there are some things you do need to be aware of when using the outputs on a GS4 drive. The two built-in relay outputs are in parameters 317 and 18, and the two built-in digital outputs are in parameters 319 and 20. The 6 option card outputs drive either the 2 digital outputs on the combo card or the 6 outputs on the relay card. So you get either 2 additional discrete outputs or 6 additional relay outputs, not both. And look at this. There are 5 virtual outputs. They're used by the PLC just like regular coils, they just don't physically drive anything. These virtual inputs are particularly helpful if you need to set a status bit for an external device to monitor via the COM cards, for example. All discrete outputs default to no function, but the relays default to error status and drive running status. You may have noticed earlier that when I enabled the drive, this LED turned on. It's connected to relay 2, which was still set to the default drive running status. Parameter 343 lets you set the behavior of the outputs. Do you want them to act as normally open or normally closed contacts? The default is normally open. Parameter 347 shows you graphically which outputs are active. That's really handy when you're trying to debug your system. Parameter 349 shows you which outputs are used by the drive and which are used by the PLC. That's really important to understand. If the PLC side of the drive uses an output, then that output is automatically owned by the PLC. And whatever drive-related function you assigned it in the parameters is overridden. So for example, suppose we tell output 1, which is parameter 319, that we want it to indicate when we have an undervoltage condition by entering a 10 into parameter 319. Well, in this case, it won't work, because we see that digital output 1, which is the 4th bit location, is in use by the PLC. And it doesn't matter if the PLC is in run or stop mode. If the output is referenced in the latter code, then the drive functionality that we specified for that output will be overridden. Which is why parameter 349 is so important. You can see at a glance which outputs are owned by the PLC, which means if you try to use them for a drive function, the drive function will be ignored. So be sure to keep an eye on that. The PLC numbers the outputs differently than the drive. The good news is you don't have to remember that, because the latter instructions show both the PLC's designation and the drive's terminal numbers. Section 2 of the user manual has a great graphic that shows you exactly how the outputs are wired and even includes the specs for each output. Now, if you use a digital output to drive an external relay, please do yourself a favor and add a surge absorber across the relay's coil. Check out these videos if you want to know why it's so important to protect your digital outputs. And I'll give you a hint. The couple bucks you spend on the surge absorber will save you a lot of time and money. Check out this handy table in Appendix C. It has everything we just covered in one easy-to-reference place, so you don't have to memorize any of this. The terminal numbers versus the PLC names for those terminals, which drive parameter controls which output, and what their default settings are, how to define the normally open versus normally closed state of the output, how to monitor the output status, and how to tell if the PLC is controlling an output, and a complete list of all the possible drive functions you can use if the PLC is not controlling the output. And there's another chart for the option card outputs, which covers the 2 outputs on the combo card and the 6 relay outputs on that card, and one more table that covers the virtual outputs. Finally, if you remove these 2 screws, you can pull out the terminal board so you can do your wiring where it's easier to work outside the drive. When it's done, just slide it back in and reattach the screws. This slot 3 up here is where the optional I/O cards go. Just plug the one in you need, screw it in place. You would then run your wires directly into this terminal block on the I/O card. Click here to learn more about the GS4 drives, click here to learn about AutomationDirect's free support options, and click here to be notified when we publish new videos.